Hello, I am Mal. I'm back with my buddy IDED, and we're continuing our multiplayer campaign here in the Master of Orion Early Access, and things are going pretty well, but last episode we ran into a couple of hiccups, wouldn't you say, IDED?
When you say a couple of hiccups, would that be both of our fleets getting destroyed?
Yeah, just minor hiccups, like our fleets getting decimated.
I like that's your name for it. Is that just a hiccup, was it?
It's just a hiccup, it's fine.
Not a major setback.
I think I mentioned this to you when we were off camera, but it looks like the Sakura and the human also signed a truce, which is not, that's not good for us.
Yeah, they finally caught on to what we've been doing and playing them against each other, and they've now decided that they're going to play us against each other in the sense of decimating us from both sides.
Yeah, I'm a little concerned about it. I mean, so far, they haven't moved in another, like, actual proper fleet, which I'm happy about, but yeah, like, right now, my biggest fleet is 1,600 military power. That's not much.
Yes, definitely not. I don't think I even have another fleet that's got any kind of military power, if anything, but I'll check into that very shortly. Not a good situation, however we look at it, really. It's not a good situation, I don't know. So it's like mass production of anything we can get our hands on at this point then, really. That's
what I did. I queued up a bunch of destroyers and free. I'm like, build it quick! Yeah. Do it now!
Really do kind of need that. any chance you guys know how to work a double shift?
Yeah. If so. Like, get on it, boys. We need some help, quick style.
Yeah, all right. Well, I've got a little fleet here of 7,000, which is two cruisers. That's all it is. But
that's better than anything I've got right now.
Yeah, well, it's sat right outside the Simus system. Just sitting around waiting for stuff to happen, really. But yeah, kind of need to sort out this situation a little bit.
Well, here we were thinking we had it wrapped up, right?
Yeah, well, this is it. I thought, it's not going to take long now. Got to be almost at the end of this run. But
there we go. I got a proper cruiser. That's good. That's a help.
Yeah, apparently I was very much mistaken on the idea that we were almost done. I've got enough credits, though. I might just start buying stuff.
Oh, do you? Really?
That's I've got nice. 2,000 credits.
Oh, that's a lot. Yeah.
So I'm just thinking when things get down to the price level that I could speed things up, I might just do that.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Going to the next one. Uh-oh. What's moving in? What is that over there? Oh, there's a Cylon scout or something over there at that wormhole.
I'm not too worried about their scouts. They can take as many looks as they want. Not going to change the end result.
I was like, I don't really need those like listening posts. And then I went ahead and built them. And I'm like, man, I'm kind of glad that I built them now.
Yeah, all of a sudden they're very important.
Yeah, they weren't, but now, yeah, they kind of sort of really are, so that's a good thing that they're there.
Okay, I'm literally just researching at random at this point. I don't think I'm focusing properly on what I'm doing. I'm just kind of researching just to progress myself as quickly as possible to the next turn, just because the desperation to handle some of these situations. Ooh! That listening post upgrade was really good. I can now see most of their systems.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, I can see what's going on. Ooh.
I'm working on, what tech am I working on? I think teaching methods right now.
I'm on cyber technics, apparently.
Oh, GNN.
Oh, what's happened?
Oh, deadly plague contained. Okay, good.
All right, you sorted out your situation. That's good to know. All right, so let's have a look at what's going on here. What's this? Oh, just one lonely frigate in that system. I might move in. I really, really, really just want to start blasting into these Sakura. I don't know. I'm getting really impatient for the need to destroy them. I suppose I'm kind of worried now with the alliance with the humans. I'm kind of like, well...
they don't have an alliance. They're just at peace.
Well, yeah, I suppose.
You know, my thing is that away. when I lost that fleet, you know what wasn't included in that military power number?
What?
4 troop transports. So not only did I lose my fleet, I lost the ground forces with it.
Oh, no.
That was freaking painful.
Oh, no, that's not good. Yeah, I'm literally just... butchering my way through upgrading stuff as quickly as possible. I'm eating my credits pretty damn quickly. I'm down to 1,200 now from like 2,000 odd. But with good reason. At the end of the day, we really do need to start our progression back up very quickly. And Ursa 2 really has a bad pollution problem that I need to sort out. So how's it looking for the production on your side then?
It's
how far are you from having a fleet again?
Well, let me take a look here. I'll actually have a semi-proper fleet in about 13 turns.
Okay, that's not bad.
So as long as they don't come push on us right now, and I do have defenses, so...
yeah,
like these systems
well,
have like,
as you said, they've upgraded those military posts that you can hold a point. That's good to know.
Yeah, and I have star bases and missile bases and stuff, so hopefully it'll be all right. My problem is that my big production worlds. I mean, even on my biggest production world, it takes like 11 turns for me to build a top end cruiser because they're so expensive.
Yeah, this is it. Well, it's because you decided to put all those battle pods in there, buddy.
This is true. This is true.
You want big firepower, then you've got to pay the big price. Hopefully not the ultimate price, though, which is the one. That's the one we're avoiding. Open borders? I think not, buddy.
Who wants open borders?
Sakura. I just want to be able to walk through my systems, basically. It's just like, no, I think not, buddy.
You're not at war with them?
No, apparently not, even though I destroyed a load of their stuff. That didn't count as war.
And they've got, oh, because like, you didn't attack. Yeah, if you attack and open space each other, then it doesn't count. It, for whatever reason, doesn't count as an act of war. I went to the next turn.
Okay, I'm just wondering if I should move in my cruisers and destroy some of their stuff.
I wouldn't.
No?
I wouldn't risk taking any losses right now. I mean, you don't have enough forces there. Do you have any troop transports? Can you actually take anything from them?
No, but I could bombard their planets.
You could, but wouldn't... I mean, if we're going to war with them, I'd like to take some of those structures intact and enslave some of their people.
Yeah, no, too true, too true. All right, then, let's get that cross-prospecting on the way. What fleet is it that needs orders? These guys. All right, well, we'll just put them on guard now for this turn. Yeah, they're joining up those frigates, though. So, yeah, like, I could have destroyed them last turn. Yeah, admittedly. It's obvious that we did take out a significant amount of their resources during that fight, though. I think that fleet we saw, I think that was their fleet. At the moment, all I can see in their turf is frigates. Like ones, if you know what I mean. Not like teams of frigates, like singular frigates. I don't know. I have a feeling that we may have actually pushed down their military power quite significantly. Does the path to victory let us see that?
Yeah, that's like the only way we can see anything right now since there's no espionage yet.
So,
I mean, they're at... It gives us a score. It doesn't give us their military power. Every once in a while, GNN will.
I don't know. I'm kind of suspicious of their military power.
Actually,
at
hold on. Let me see if this is in here. Oh, it is in here. So go to Path to Victory and then click View Timeline Graph. And then you can select the Sakura at the bottom. And then you can say, hey, what's your score? What's your army size?
So when we lost ours, they lost theirs too.
Yeah.
But theirs hasn't rebuilt and ours is rebuilt.
yours
has anyway. Mine hasn't.
They're a little bit below me. Where's yours? Let me look at yours.
I'm very much below, but...
Combined, we're higher than them. So this is usually information. This usually you would get from espionage. So they're letting us, I guess that they're just giving you this information, but generally this would only be available once you had established a spy network in their empire. But still, it's kind of cool that it's in here.
I'm building cruisers pretty much everywhere, which is good. I have got a lot of production of that style of stuff. So, what can I get away with at the moment? Not much, by the looks of it. Doing pollution cleanup, by the looks of it, on a lot of my planet at the moment. All right. Then now I'm going to move to the next then. Just waiting around, waiting for stuff to build. There we go, another cruiser. Let's take that through to the area we need it to be in. It takes 7 turns to get there. How long would it actually take to get to? All right, yeah, right. It's quicker to go through the wormhole. Right, next turn. Ah, truce of the humans has expired. Ah, that's good to see. Is that my truce or is that going to be anyone's truce? It didn't really show me when I clicked it.
You're telling you your impact, right?
All right. Fair enough then. My truce to the humans is gone. That's fine though. I've built up Kif enough now to not have to care. I think I might start producing some fleet there. Might upgrade my destroyer design quickly.
Okay. I can see if there's any more tech I'm supposed to send you.
Yeah, I suppose I should really check on that one as well.
Nope. No new tech. Yeah, from an efficiency standpoint, in terms of command points, I was looking at military power. The bigger ships obviously do grant a better economy of scale in terms of command point versus military power output than the smaller craft. Like, for instance, destroyers take 2 command points. I can get a total military output of maybe 1,600 versus a cruiser, which is 4 command points, but I get a military output of 7,100. That's so double would be 3,000. So it's almost twice as efficient command point to military power. Which I guess makes sense. So you're right. For multiplayer, you should basically just build large ships. However, in single player, if tactical combat, it changes things significantly because the smaller ships are faster and you can build them more quickly. And there's a lot of reasons to have them in your fleet mix. In this, basically build the biggest thing and smack as many, you know, battle pods and stuff on it as you can. Well, I'm ready to go when you are.
Ooh, sorry, just checking some destroyers on the build. My latest version. Cool. Alright, next turn. Has the pollution not been cleaned up here yet? Thank goodness. All right, then. What's here? Oh, that's my cruiser that's en route. Ursa really desperately needs its pollution situation sorted out. It's not good. Okay, I'm just going to advance the next turn, then. Yeah, they are... The Sakura are definitely trying to attempt to build another army.
Oh, are they now?
Yeah, they're just basically collecting all their frigates in Simus. They just all keep coming down there and like stacking next to Simus 2. They just all keep on adding themselves onto the one that was there. I think they're up to 3 there. There's another 2 by the looks of it coming in. So they could be building a fleet as we speak.
I'm okay with them building a fleet, as long as they don't come our way with it yet. So I'm not ready. Well, I mean, I don't know. I've got 10,000 military strength, plus a military outpost guarding the warp point, so I'm not defenseless, but... It's not idyllic.
Alright, I'm going to quickly check to see if I've got anything I can send you. Nope, no exchange tech available. Fair enough. Goodbye. Alright, I'm going to move those back to that listening post. And put them on guard. Oh, I need to do some cleanup here. Really not good. Let's put that onto the current build, unfortunately. On my production planets, the pollution is just way too high. can't leave it like that.
I've got one like that too.
Yeah, it's kind of, you're looking at it and you're just like, oh, but I really want to produce more of these things. And then you're kind of looking at it going, but if I do that, I'm just sacrificing, basically, for the sake of getting production down a little bit sooner. Whereas I'd very much rather have loads of big ships available to me than sort out the little pollution problems. But I'm sure the negative impact overall is not going to be good. Oh, look at them building up this fleet down here. Welcome. All right, GNN, what's going on?
Data of the galaxy.
Ah, nice. The state of the galaxy.
Current number... Well, we got that firmly under control.
Yeah. Only because we're stopping them from moving out at this point in time. Yeah, so now they've got 5 frigates in that fleet down there. So they are building up and the sick one's just coming in. They literally are just pumping all their frigates into this one little army.
Yeah, I kind of figured that's what was going to happen.
Right, I'm just going straight to next turn. Thing is, I still think I've got more military power than they've got in that little fleet with my couple of cruisers, which is going to turn into 3 cruisers very shortly as well. Pretty much all my worlds are at 100% morale, though. I've only got a couple that are at 90. I've got a lot of worlds that are purely focusing on trade goods, though.
I'm on the next turn, by the way.
Alrighty then, I shall do the same.
Something else I hope they put in is rally points. That your fleets, you know, you can just set ships from a certain system to automatically move somewhere else.
Go to that point as soon as they're constructed, basically.
I hope they add that.
Yeah, no, that would definitely be a nice facility. I'm just going to go straight to the next turn. As all we're doing at the moment is sort of waiting on production. Get a fleet together. Might as well just keep hammering through it, I suppose. Turn 207. Yeah, they really are. They're just pumping out frigates like there's no tomorrow. So they're literally just going for the quickest thing they can produce to get the most military power as quickly as possible.
Of course.
Does make sense, I suppose, but... Yeah, okay, I'm going full production on Ferris. Gonna start turning it into a proper production colony. Alright, next cruiser's come through. Looking forward to smashing some face.
Yeah, I am too. I need just a minute, I'm updating a ship design.
No worries, no worries whatsoever. So what are you adding to this one then?
I just actually unlocked Battleship, so I'm building that archetype right now.
Okay, nice.
Feel it single unit, polish flat to target, drop the further, play like range. Yeah, I don't want that. Holy crap, these things have a lot of slots on them.
Yeah?
Battleships have 6 weapon slots.
Ooh.
That's kind of crazy.
What's the total weight capacity of them?
1,200.
And with battle pods?
That's with battle pods, yeah.
Oh, that's with battle pods. Okay, that's still a hell of a lot. How much is that going to set you back, though? That's the real question.
I haven't even put weapons on it yet, and it's 402 production costs. Yeah, it's
not cheap.
Right?
So you're going to have to go for full production colony when you start building that, then? Everybody
on
production.
Absolutely.
I don't think I've got any colonies that are full production at the moment. Got a lot that are very highly focused on it, but they still have focus on food and research going on at the same time. But maybe I think I'm going to have to start maxing out my production. But the Bolrafi are really good for their production anyway. They really have got really high production. Seems to be very much the nature of the race.
I wish multiplayer had the tactical combat.
It would be nice, but I can understand why it doesn't, just because of the waiting that would be required.
Yeah, but if you're the other player, you should be able to watch it.
Yeah, merely. If they put in a spectate option. But then, I suppose they'd have to have like a little screen come up with like a GNN, watch the battle, and then offer all the battles that are currently going on. So they'd sort of synchronize all battles happening at once.
Yeah, yeah. So that might be why it's not, because that would be problematic. I don't know.
Yeah. It's a nice idea, though. You never know. They might catch on to it later. There's always, always the chance.
I'm having a hard time filling this thing up. Like, I think surely that's going to be enough, and then it's not. Holy crap. Okay, there we go. Got it.
Yeah, so it
1200 production to produce one battleship. So even if I do it on my top production world,
it's going to be waiting a long time.
30 turns to build one of them.
Oof. Yeah, so that's a long-term investment right there.
Of course, it's single-handedly going to be worth as much as my entire fleet right now, so I guess it's, you know.
Yeah, so there's the potential there for an extreme benefit. But then, you know, at an extreme cost.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Okay, going to the next one.
1 second, I'm just quickly changing around some of my colony situation. I'm just quickly basically going into mass production is the plan at this moment in time. So I'm just quickly altering all of my colonies quickly to change their focus, so to speak, away from research and on to production of some sort. And I do have a hell of a lot going on. Okay. Alright, and I'll quickly advance turns. There we go. Right, more research is finished. Oh, class 3 shield, finally. Alright, the warp dissipate is quite cool, but I imagine that's only once again for tactical combat.
Yeah, otherwise it doesn't matter. You can't even retreat from combat now, so it's not in yet.
Yeah, so it serves no purpose right at this point in time. I can't believe how long the research tree goes on for. So much of it.
Like I said, though, we're about to reach that tipping point where it's not going to take very long to do the research. Especially, we wrap up some of these battles or wars or whatever that we got going on, and we don't really need to produce like a fleet, or we've got a fleet that's survived. You know what I mean? Like, it's, you know, there's no reason to build more ships because we've already got our command point cap filled. At that point, you just start switching over colonies to complete research because there's really nothing else for them to do. Go on to the next turn, by the way.
Okay. I think I'll mostly be joining you on that very shortly. And just quickly, once again, changing around some of my colonies to focus more on what is needed. I've got one volcanic planet that has no food, basically, generation available on it at all. Makes sense, of course. All right, next turn. There we go. Right, got a load of cruisers there. All right, how long do I actually get some more ships? Because I need them. 25 turns, that seems like a bit excessive. We're at max population here. Why are we even bothering with food then?
Oh, you have to have a certain number of people on it just so you don't go negative, but yeah, otherwise.
Yeah, if you're getting +4 food, though. And don't worry, I'm not worried about producing additional food at this moment in time, so that one can go like that. Yeah, that takes my production up nicely. So Earth is now plus 23 production per turn. Still going to take me 16 turns though to produce one cruiser. All right, let's go into next turn. I just want to go stomp them. Stomping! I need to do this.
I want to also, but I know what's going to happen if we do that.
I know.
If we try to do that, we're going to end up getting punched right in the face.
Well, this is it. Well, their fleet is growing quite steadily now. Earlier, I could have made it so they couldn't have built a fleet, but now I think it's the point where they actually may have the ability to do damage to me.
Oh, is it looking like a risky proposition now?
It may well do. Well, I'll check it on next turn to see exactly how many ships are in this fleet they've got here. But I've noticed that every couple of turns, they're building a frigate and sending it down. And there's obviously, I think they've got two worlds in the, is it Trephon system?
Yeah.
That are producing ships. So every couple of turns, there'll be two frigates that will pop out and then they'll come straight down into Simus and join the Simus 2 fleet.
See, if we could actually move towards them, and even if we just didn't take those worlds, but just destroyed them to deny them the ability to build.
Yeah, this is it. I think this is the thing I'm going to aim to do.
I mean, I think at this point, I got my fleet. It's pretty solid now.
All right, let's have a check. How many's in this fleet now, then? All right, so their fleet now consists of, can I collect it? See, now they've got 7,900. Power in there, so they've got a cruiser in there as well now.
And this is where is it at?
Simus 2, the original system we invaded. Okay. I've still got double their power though, because they're 7,900 and I'm on 14,000 with my free cruisers, but it still looks like it may be a risky proposition until I get another one through. Yeah. All right. Well, I'm just gonna keep advancing to next turn. I'll wait till you're ready.
Well, I guess I'll start sending the fleet that way.
I don't mind being the sacrificial lamb to jump in there and do as much damage as possible before your fleet rolls in and splats them across the space.
I would just like to be able to take advantage of what we're doing. So I'm gonna build a couple of troop transports and see if I can't take some of these worlds from them.
So, how's Ryland doing pollution-wise? Only on 18. All right, let's build 5 destroyers. All right, this cruiser can go up and through the warp point. How long till I get my next cruiser? Oh yes, we're taking down pollution. Oh, I can't be bothered with the pollution situation. You can deal with it for now. Deal with that dirty water.
I can't be bothered with your nonsense complaining about pollution, silly planet.
Yeah, exactly. Global warming. We've been dealing with it for years. It's fine. You're not going to instantly die of radiation poisoning. It takes a while.
It takes a smidge of time, yeah. So don't worry. Don't worry.
Exactly. We'll work on it later. Come on, this is standard human politics, mate. They are actually trying to build something as well over here. It looks like they've got a space factory, most probably building a military facility.
If they're smart, that's what they're building, yeah.
Alright, I'm going to advance another turn. They've just joined up another frigate to that fleet. Alright, so what are they at now? Now 8,600. Mainly frigates though. Yeah, it's pretty much all frigates and one cruiser. There's a hell of a lot of frigates they've got in there now. So obviously that's what they're doing. They're just mass building the cheapest ship to get military might. Maybe I should have done the same, really. Maybe we should be producing like loads of the cheaper shit. But the thing is there's not that much damage it can do.
Well, not only that, but again, from a command point standpoint, it's not efficient. If we had tactical combat, I would be saying the complete opposite, that we should be building a lot of small ships and packing as much long-range firepower, i.e. missiles, into them as possible, because that strategy works. Like, when I'm playing single-player, frigates and destroyers loaded down with missiles, and I just fire them off and then back everything away, and then fire off again. I mean, it's actually...
devastating,
the devs are going to have to adjust that, because it's, like, too good.
Standard, like, CNC tank rush, basically. But just with, just with long range, basically. Sniper rush, I suppose. I mean, I did love that about the CNC games, when you got, was it Natalia? Was it Natalia in CNC? The Commando? Do you remember that?
I don't.
It was a legendary one when you got that one troop who could literally just take out like 50 to 100 normal guys.
Oh!
Just walk in
guess
there.
Guess who's offering me a peace treaty?
The Sacra?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm not surprised by that. They've already tried it with me. They want one of us to basically not get involved in the combat so they have the opportunity to win.
I'm declining. I'm going to acquiesce to your request there, Sacra.
How far is this from this? Yeah, it's only a couple of turns until I get another one through. Another cruiser's being built there. Another cruiser being built here. Destroyers being built there. Got 68 command points. I'm just not using it. So I'm just like,
is a ridiculous number of command points. You have 68 command points? That's crazy, dude.
Oh, this is it. And I was just like, I really, really need to start like pumping out a massive military might.
You know what I just realized?
What's that?
We are ridiculously over on time.
Oh, are we?
Yeah, like way over.
Oh, no.
But that's what I'm saying. We have such a good time playing the game. It's like, what? Oh, it's supposed to... Okay.
Well, everyone can enjoy the fact that they got a really long episode.
There you go.
Feel lucky.
All right, you want to move to the next turn?
Yeah, let's move to the next turn.
All right, folks. Well, I think we're going to go... We've been at war with them, but I think we're actually going to go back to active war with the Sakura in the next one. So, hope you look forward to that. And that you enjoyed this episode with myself and IDED. And if you did, consider hitting that thumbs up. Thanks so much for watching. And until next time, I'm Mal, he's IDED, and we will see you later.
See you soon.